हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल टू ऑल ऑफ यू? जस्ट राइट इन द चैट बॉक्स। ओके, जस्ट अ मिनट, लेट मी शेयर माई टूडेज प्रेजेंटेशन। So in the last class, we already discussed the conversion from NFA to DFA. So in today's, we are going to discuss a new topic, and this topic is very important, and its name is minimization of DFA. So many of the times in your RTO exams, this topic gives questions of mark 8 marks, and sometimes the question can be asked is of 15 marks. So this topic is very important from your examination point of view. So let us discuss. So DFA minimization stands for converting a given DFA to its equivalent DFA with minimum number of states. So the equivalent DFA functions the same as the original DFA, but it is having minimum number of states than the original DFA. So let us discuss the algorithm related with the minimization of DFA. So suppose there is a DFA which we are denoted with capital D, and it consists of 5 tuples, as we already discussed, which recognizes a language capital L. Then the minimized DFA, which is represented as D dash with its tuples. So here its tuples are with Q dash, then the input symbol sigma, then the Q naught. The initial state is same as the original DFA initial state. Then the del dash means the transition function is different as from the original DFA transition function, and f dash means the final states of the minimized DFA is different than the original DFA's final states can be constructed for the language L. It means that the minimized DFA will also accept the language which is recognized by the original DFA D. So let us discuss the algorithm for minimization of DFA. So in the step one, we eliminate all the dead states and inaccessible states from the given DFA. So, as we already discussed, the dead states are those states after reaching on the dead state, we cannot move to the other states, or we cannot move to the final state of the DFA. And in this, and the inaccessible states are those states which cannot be reached from the initial state of the DFA. So, in the first step, we need to eliminate all the dead states and the inaccessible states from the given DFA. Then the step two, we will divide Q, the set of states, into two sets. One set will contain all final states, and the other set will contain all the non-final states. So this partition is called P naught. So you need to remember this step. This step is very important. We need to partition all the states into two parts. One part will contain all the all the states which are non-final states, and the other part will contain all the states which are final state. We name them this partition as P naught. Now, according to step 3, we initialize k equal to 1. Then in the step 4, find P k by partitioning the different sets of P k minus 1. Here we are given the generalization according to the algorithm. So if we take k is equal to 1, then in the step 4 we will find the p1, and the p k minus 1 means the p0. So in the step 2 we got the p naught, then we increment the k with 1. So in the step 4 we find p1 by partitioning the different sets of p naught. So in each set of p naught we will take all possible pair of states. If two states of a set are distinguishable, we will split the sets into different sets in pk. So we will discuss when it very clearly when we are discussing the problems related to this algorithm later. Then according to step 5, we will stop this algorithm when pk is equal to pk minus 1. That means no change in the partition. It means that whatever the states present in the pk minus 1 partition will also present in the pk partition. At that point we need to stop this algorithm. Then according to step 6, all states of one set are merged into one. So number of states in minimized DFA will be equal to the number of sets in pk. So this is the algorithm for conversion of minimization of DFA from the given DFA. So all of you need to remember or understand this algorithm, because sometimes in your exam this algorithm is also asked. If the question is of 15 mark, that you need to solve the question related to the minimization of DFA, and also you need to write the steps of this algorithm. So all of you need to understand it clearly. Now write in the chat box so that we can proceed further. Okay. Now there is a term, distinguishable. So how to find whether the two states in partition PK are distinguishable or not? So in a general way, two states QI and QJ are distinguishable in partition PK if for any input symbol A, such that del QIA and del QJA are in different sets in partition PK minus 1, then this condition we say that the partitions are, or the two states in the partition PK are distinguishable. Otherwise, these two states are not distinguishable. In order to understand this concept better, we need to solve the algorithm. Sorry, we need to solve the questions which are based on this algorithm. So let us solve the question related to this algorithm. So a question one is given, minimize the following DFA. So as you can see on your screen that a DFA is given, and in this DFA there are six states from Q0 to Q5 are given. Now we need to apply the algorithm for minimization of DFA. So according to the algorithm, स्टेप नंबर वन, वी नीड टू इलिमिनेट द डेड स्टेट एंड इनएसेसिबल स्टेट्स ऑफ दिस एनएफए, ऑफ दिस सॉरी ऑफ दिस डीएफए. सो एज यू कैन सी हियर, द स्टेट्स, एज यू कैन चेक ईच एंड एवरी स्टेप, आइदर टू चेक वेदर द वेदर any state is a dead state or an inaccessible state or not. So we start with the initial state Q naught. So we need to check. So from Q naught we can move to Q1, from Q naught we can move to Q3, and from Q naught we can move to Q3, and from Q3 we can move to Q5, but from Q3 we cannot move to Q4 and Q2. Now we need to check whether from the other path we can move to Q2 or Q4. So from this, from the Q1, from Q0 to Q1 path, there is no path to reach from Q1 to Q2. So it means that we cannot reach Q2 and Q4 from the state, from the initial state Q0. So it means that the states Q2 and Q4 are unreachable states. So we need to eliminate them. So basically we need to remove these two states Q2 and Q4. So we left with only four states, Q0, Q1, Q3 and Q5. So our original DFA will already reduce to four states, because Q2 and Q4 are unreachable states. So we need to eliminate it according to step number one of the minimization of DFA algorithm. So all of you understand it? Till now just write in the chat box so that we can proceed further. So cute. Now we are left with only four states. Now we need to convert the transition diagram of the DFA into the transition table for better understanding. So we need to draw the table. So we have three columns: present state, then the next state for input 0, and the next state for input 1. Now from the state Q0, on getting input 0, we move to Q1 state, and from state Q0, on getting input 1, we move to state Q3. Now we need to write the transitions of state Q1. Now on getting input 0 on state Q1, we move to state Q0, and on state Q1, on getting input 1, we move to state Q3. Now we need to write the transitions of state Q3. So as you can see here, from Q3, on getting input either 0 or input 1, we move to Q5. So we can write to Q5 here. Now on writing the transitions on input 0 and 1 for Q5 state, as you can see here, on Q5 a self loop is there on both the input. So we reach to Q5 on getting the input either 0 or input 1. So that's how our transition table is completed. So this transition table we can use for solving the problem. So just now we can deal with the transition table. So out of these four states, we made first partition P naught. So according to the step two of our algorithm for minimization of DFA, we need to partition in it two parts. So first part will contain all the states having all the non-final states, and the other part will contain all the final states. So here Q naught and Q1 are non-final states, so they are in one part, and Q3 and Q5 are the final states, so they are in other part. Now to calculate P1, we will check whether sets of partition P naught can be partitioned or not. So for set Q naught and Q1, we individually check each state with its corresponding inputs. So del Q naught with input 0, we move to Q1 according to the transition table, and with Q naught with input 1, we move to Q3. Now for the state Q1 with input 0, we move to Q naught, and for input Q1, here we are writing Q1 with input 1, we move to Q3. So Q naught, Q1 states are not distinguishable. So here we need to check the distinguishability feature of these two states. So why these two are not distinguishable states? Because on getting the input 0 on both the states Q naught and Q1, they are in the same partitions. As you can see here, on getting input 0 on Q naught and Q1, we are at the same partition. Here we are getting Q1 and here we are getting Q naught. So Q naught and Q1 are in the same partition, and on getting input 1 on Q naught and Q1, we are getting Q3 in both the cases. So we are in the same partition, so that's why they are not distinguishable here. So therefore the Q naught and Q1 set will not be partitioned in P1 because they are not distinguishable. So this point is very important. So all of you understand it till now, just write in the chat box, because this point is very important to find out whether whether two or more sets in a partition are distinguishable or not. Anjali, Himanshu, Avinash, just write in the chat box. Okay. So moving forward. Now we need to check this same process for the next partition. So for set Q3 Q5, which consists of final states. So for state Q3 with input 0, we are getting Q5, and on state Q3 with input 1, we get Q5, and with the state Q5 on input 0, we are getting Q5, and on state Q5 with input 1, we get Q5. So only 2 minutes are remaining, so we will complete it in the fast way. So as you can see here, since Q3 and Q5 transit to the same state on 0 and 1, so we skip Q5 and then replace Q5 by Q3 in the transition table. So the second partition will consist of Q0, Q1 and Q3. So now we we need to calculate P2 in the same way. So we proceed to calculate Q2. Now in Q naught with 0 input we did Q1, with 1 input we did Q3, and Q1 we did this. So in the same way, Q naught, Q1 are not distinguishable. For set Q3 we did Q3, Q naught, and with this we did Q3. So the third partition also we did Q naught, Q1, and Q3. So P2 and P1 are same. So we should stop here. So the number of states in the minimized DFA equal to number of sets in P2 according to our algorithm. So this is the transition table. So we have only two sets, Q naught, Q1, and Q3. So you can write Q naught, Q1, and here you can write Q3. Can write Q naught, Q1, and here you can write Q3. And Q3 is the final state. Now Q naught, Q1, on getting 0, you can move to Q naught, Q1, and on getting 1, you move to Q3, and on Q3, on getting 0 and 1, you can move to Q3. So that's it. So we minimized this DFA of 6 state to only 2 states of doing, and this DFA is doing the same function as that of the original DFA of 6 states. So that's it for today's class. So thank you very much for attending this class. So we are going to discuss the next questions related to this algorithm in the later class. Now you can leave this meeting.